For 10 weeks, 20 RuneScape content creators will be competing for a massive prize. Along the way, they'll face never-before-seen challenges, brutal eliminations, and a couple of twists. Welcome to the Gielinor Games.
What's going on, guys? B0aty here. Welcome to the Gielinor Games Season 2. I feel I'm going to be a strong all-around competitor in this season after completing my one-man army series, which consisted of excelling in almost every aspect of the game. More modern day, I'm testing this further by playing the hardcore Iron Man game mode and also improving endgame content on the main. Any trivia challenges? Say no more.
Hey, I'm Settled, and I think I'm probably best known for locking my ultimate Iron Man to Mauritania. I'm a well-rounded player overall. I think my strengths are sort of the game knowledge area. I mean, I am here to win. I don't think there's anything else that's on my mind except for that.
What's up? Good to see you. I'm Skill Specs. Thanks to Super inviting me to the old Gielinor Games. I'm ready to mop up the scene. I'll be eliminated in a terrible fashion.
I'm Torvesta. I'm known mainly for PvP, so my strengths going into this are obviously going to be PvP. My PvM knowledge and skilling is pretty much next to zero, so I'm hoping I'm paired with someone who knows a bit about PvM.
My name is Nine Rain, also known as the White Wolf of RuneScape. I have a PK series where I'm getting a kill at every combat level in RuneScape, and then I have a fake Iron Man. I'm kind of known as a bit of an underdog, and life's going well. I'm glad to be that guy.
Hey, I'm Poison Potion, or PP for short. I'm known for my high-res hardcore Iron Man series on YouTube, where most of my progress on the account is centered around the wilderness. I think my strengths are a general knowledge of PvP and PvM, as well as an ability to stay alive no matter what the circumstance.
My name is Elliot, or Skidler. I stream on Twitch. I've been playing RuneScape since I was 11. Usually I'm just playing like my endgame Iron Man, where I do solo raids every day and receive no loot. But other than that, I was a PK for a long time, like a lot of hybrid in and tribrid in.
My name is Didabitter. I'm known for PKing, probably more for DMM as well, as I've competed in a lot of that. Recently, I did 2 months of Trailblazer League, which expanded my game knowledge a whole lot, which I'm hoping will be enough for me to keep competing in the Gielinor Games.
Hello, my name is Verf. I'm from the Netherlands, and I'm mostly known for the Karamja Oni series and unique account builds. I think I have a good general knowledge of the game and got some good PKing experience as well.
Hey guys, my name is EVscape. I'm Australia's number one PVMer. There's absolutely no doubt about that. No one better than me on the sticks when it comes to PVM. I'm known for also probably being the most handsome man in the RuneScape content creator scene.
I am Jimmy with a 1. I'm known for By Release, a series where I do the quests in the order of release date. Great series. I'm back for my second season, and this time, I'm gonna win.
Hello, I am C Engineer. Last season, I ended up in the top 12 of GG. This year, I set myself the goal to reach the finals. I'm mostly known for doing PvP, especially hunting hardcore Iron Man. Doing challenges.
Hi, I'm Solo Mission. You probably know me from temporary game modes like Deadman mode or Leagues, or from one of my many Iron Man accounts. I would say my strengths and challenges are pretty much anything RuneScape related. I would say I'm a jack of all trades, master of none. Where I fall down, like in the last season of Gielinor Games, is when stuff comes in like anagrams. I don't want to see that sort of stuff. I want it to keep it RuneScape, and hopefully I'll be fine.
You already know who it is, the season one champion,
Zanzi.
Back for another season of the Gielinor Games to clean up yet another roster of competitors that are just simply not on my level. And I'm telling you right now, I'm keeping that trophy.
Hello, my name is Batoso. I'm an Oldschool RuneScape YouTuber that makes challenge videos with my bestest friend in the whole wide world, Tanzu, aka David. I had a taste last season, Soup, but I wanted some more, so I've come back to try and a little bit of redemption from last time. There was a bit of an early exit. I'm hoping to stay a bit longer this time.
Hey gamers, I am Guns Chili. I often go by In Debt for a Pet, as I run a series on YouTube where I stake my bank every time I get a pet. Last season, I won Gielinor Games, and I hope to replicate said accomplishment this season. Lots of love and good luck to all the gamers.
My name is Zulu, and last season, I made it to the finals with Frame. We were so close to winning, and I'm back again to claim victory this time. I think my previous experience will come in handy against a lot of the newcomers, and I'm excited to see what's in store.
Hello, my name is Kem Q. Super excited to be back to Gielinor Games. Unfortunately, came short, but I think I'm well-equipped to win this season of Gielinor Games.
Guess who just got back?
Hey, I'm Flutton. I'm known for being a giant freaking noob in the last Gielinor Games. So last season I was pretty shy and nervous, and this season I'm hoping to let my personality come through a bit more. They were asking if you were around,
how you was, where you could be. My name is Frame. Some of you might know me for being a pro PBMer in the RuneScape scene. Just recently I achieved my Infernal Cape on RuneScape, and I'm here to seek revenge from last season. I'm coming back to fight for first place in the second season of Gielinor Games.
Thanks to Displate, this season of Gielinor Games is represented beautifully with an incredible piece of artwork created by Volkaban, the official Gielinor Games Displate of Season 2. If you didn't know, Displate is a high-quality metal poster that uses a safe magnet mounting system. Hanging the poster takes no tools and can be done in minutes. If you'd like to support this season, using the link in the description, you can grab a Gielinor Games Displate for 30% off for the next 3 days, which is a great way to show your support if you like the series. And after those 3 days, you'll still get 20% off if you order 1-2 Displates, and 30% off if you order 3 or more. If you somehow don't like it, you can always grab a Buy Release or Swampletics Displate instead. Or all three if you're feeling crazy. You can also always choose from the thousands of other Displates available on the website as well. Displate is doing great things around the world. For every Displate bought, one baby tree is planted, so you're kind of saving the world by buying one. Thanks again to Volkaban for creating the artwork, and thanks to any of you who decided to grab a Gielinor Games Displate. I think it would look pretty good on your wall. Welcome everyone to the second season of Gielinor Games.
Hello.
Last season, we had Team Europe versus Team North America in an epic 6v6 battle for the superior continent. This season, you'll all be in teams again, but this time, teams of two. So, let's get you guys together. Tanzu, you'll be joined by someone you might not know well, but I want to see how you two work together. It could be very fun to watch. Your partner for this season will be Virtuoso.
Oh, man. Honestly, I think we've got this in the bag. I mean, we're the best duo in the game. Hands down, no duo comes anywhere near me and Dave. It's Walter White and Jesse Pinkman. We've got the chemistry.
But what I can say now is Jen is definitely a liability. Definitely.
I've got a feeling you two could work very well together. Up next, a couple of rookies, some new blood, here to show that they have what it takes to become GG champions, but more importantly, add an incredible amount of banter and jokes to the game. Our second team will be Skidler and Eviescape.
Coming into the season, I actually thought I was going to be paired up with D0aty, so I was really upset that I was going to be paired with D0aty, so very happy to find out that I was paired with Skidler.
If you watch me, you'll know that Jake and I have a pretty good friendship and chemistry. We did the GIMP series with Ron and Perp, and you know, we're always doing stupid shit together, basically. I was actually surprised when you put me with Jake.
You know, while we're at it, let's get a second rookie team together. These boys have been around for quite some time, some true OGs of the content creation game. More importantly, they have absolutely ruined the number 73 for the rest of our lives. Team 3 will be B0aty and SkillSpecs.
Yeah.
So I've known SkillSpecs for a long time, which means we're definitely going to have a good level of synergy. We can be good at certain aspects of the game, but if we can't pull it off as a team, it doesn't really matter. It's just going to fall apart. So I think the fact that we know each other so well and we could be so comfortable talking to each other and preparing whatever's there, then we should be able to just jump back and forth with leadership roles and easily just progress for each challenge.
He's a very strategic man, so he's going to be a difficult person to team with, because I don't have that much strategy in the old brain. But I'm going to try my best to keep up to his speed and not get carried too hard.
For this next team, we're mixing a veteran and a rookie, some old and some new blood. Last season, Flutton was one challenge away from making it to the final, but was unfortunately eliminated. This time, she's got an incredibly handsome and talented player to help her out. Flutton, you'll be joined on Team 4 by Nine Rain.
Oh, making moves. What's up, Jimmy?
Hey, man.
I'm honestly super happy about it. I love that I get to spend a lot of time with one of my best friend's girlfriends, because there's nothing I like more than giving Jimmy crap and making him uncomfortable. So this is going to be great.
Oh, I was so excited because I actually know him. And I also think it's really funny that he normally plays as a girl character, but he changed to a guy character for like the games. And I normally play a guy character and I swap to a girl character.
Now it's time for another team of veterans, some Team EU beasts. Last season, Guns Chili helped Rakesy stay in the game by carrying him through his elimination and in the process knocked out Solo Mission. This season, you guys will have to set your differences aside because you'll have to work together. Team 5 is Guns Chili and Solo Mission.
Oh, let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
Woo!
Woo!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I was so happy to get Guns Chili as my partner. Of course, the winner of the last Gielinor Games. I couldn't ask for a better guy to be my side. Also British from Team EU. We have great chemistry, so I think we're going to go far in this competition.
Yeah, I was chuffed. Solo Mission is an all-rounder. He's very, very proactive, and he likes to think on his toes, and he's very adaptive, I guess, to challenges, because he does a lot of theory crafting himself. So yeah, very happy.
This season, I think it's safe to say we're going to see some PvP challenges, so my hope is that this team makes it to those challenges and puts on an absolute show. Legends of the Wilderness and Dead Men mode, in Team 6, we've got Torvesta and Ditterbitter.
Let's go!
Nice.
Let's go.
I was hoping it could have been someone to do a PVM, but if it's a PvP challenge, we are going to be strong.
A little bit of a worry was that we're both PKers, we're both sort of focused on the same thing, that if something that we don't have the best game knowledge comes up in and neither one of us can really carry each other, it's not going to go too great.
Last season, Zulu was super close to winning the entire game. He may have been just an eaten cabbage away from lifting the trophy. This season, I'm sure he wants to make it back to the final and win. So to help him out, he'll have the most feared man in Karamja on his side. Karamja only himself, Verf.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Brilliant.
Oh yeah.
I was pretty happy to hear I had Zulu on my team because I think he has a lot of knowledge as well. And I think together we make a pretty strong team.
Verf is a very talented, well-rounded player. With his UIM experience and with his experience just playing a one single region, I think he knows how to make the most of any situation. Verf is a very strong player. I'm excited to have him as my partner.
Speaking of Iron Man beasts, Mr. Poison Potion has graciously accepted the offer to join us this season, and I'm sure he'll be looking to make it very far into the game. To help him, he'll have the 10 HP, 11 HP, 12 HP, 13 HP, and however many more HP levels he's gotten, the Gmall powerhouse that is Mr. Chem Q.
Woo!
All right.
Woo!
Here we go.
When I found out Poison Potion was my partner, that was the moment I knew we were gonna take the win. That guy is well equipped to take on any challenge. I think because of his talents with PVM and more recently with PvP, we will be ready to take on anything that Soup has to throw us.
I've gotta say, I'm happy to have Kemp as a partner. The man's got huge knowledge of both PVM and PvP. He's an all-around good player. For whatever weak points I might have in that regard, I'm sure he's gonna be making up for them.
We've got four players left. Settled, Framed, Jimmy, and Sea Engineer. Now two of you, Framed and Jimmy, had this extremely toxic, steamy, spicy, kind of erotic love-hate relationship last season.
Jim, I'm voting you.
You're voting me, I'm voting you.
Cancel culture is coming after you, Jim. You're going
dude,
off this team.
Dude,
all last season, Framed just couldn't go 5 minutes without thinking about me or mentioning me in an episode. It took a while for us to mend our relationship. If Kevin looks at me the wrong way once this season, everything we work towards mending this relationship is out the window. I don't even care. He's always on thin ice with me, no matter what the scenario is.
As much as I know you two want to be together on a team, I'm afraid I can't make that happen, because Jimmy has fallen for another man. A man who spends quite a bit of his time in the swamp with a little old account called Swampletics. Team 9 will be Jimmy and Settle.
Man.
Well, at first I thought you were going to put me with Kevin, but I was very relieved when that didn't happen. When I saw it was down to me, Settled, Framed, and Sea Engineer, I was like, this could go one of two ways. A very disgusting, dirty season filled with a lot of arguing, or I could love this and have a great second season and get past the second episode.
Me and Jimmy have really good chemistry, so aside from us obviously not being the most talented PKers or anything like that, I think the chemistry above all else is gonna take us far.
Finally, we've got one of the cutest but smelliest couples left. Can Framed take the win after his second place last season? Can Sea Engineer make more than 12k in a money-making challenge? Well, we're going to find out, because you two are going to be team number 10.
Last in dodgeball picks.
Honestly, hearing that I got partnered up with Sea Engineer is a relief, because he's a good buddy of mine and we work pretty well together. So hopefully him and I have what it takes to go the distance and win Gielinor Games Season 2.
We are the perfect match, to be honest. He's got the expertise when it comes to PvP, and I'm a good sidekick.
So, those are the teams.
Woo! That's so cute.
Beautiful. Let's go.
Here's how this season's going to work. Every week, you guys will compete in a challenge. The winning team of that week's challenge will receive golden aprons, which gives you immunity from being nominated to that week's banning, the elimination. You'll also gain the power to automatically send one team directly into the banning. So winning a challenge gives you a lot of power. Make sure to use it wisely. Everyone else will then individually and anonymously cast one vote for which team they want to send into the banning. I would not recommend coming last in a challenge this season. If you get last place, your team will automatically receive one vote for the banning. That alone could be enough of a reason for another team to vote you into the banning. Don't get last. The team that receives the most votes will be nominated into the banning and must face off in an elimination challenge versus the team that was nominated by the Golden Apron winning team. The two teams will then fight it out in the banning. The team that wins stays in the game. Losing team is eliminated from the Gielinor Games. After many requests from last season, this season's prize pool will be viewer-sponsored. I'll be starting it off with 1 billion GP. If you'd like to contribute to the prize pool of Gielinor Games, hop in the Soup CC in-game and send me a message. The final prize pool total will be revealed at the season finale. Alright, let's get into this week's challenge. Your challenge today is called Gold Rush. A fan favorite challenge from last season, each team will have 1 hour to make as much money as they can from scratch. You may not use anything you already have in your banks, coffers, or anything else that has any items stored inside. You are also not allowed to enter your player-owned house for any reason. It's off-limits. You are allowed to use the Grand Exchange at any time. If you pick up an item, you can sell it on the GE and buy supplies or anything else you need to help you make more money. Last season, the three best methods were the Gauntlet, Zolcano, and Chinchampas. For this challenge, all of those are off-limits and cannot be done to gain any GP.
Wow.
I just learned.
Wow.
I love the Gauntlet. What the hell? Like, he's restricting that? That's ridiculous. I have no idea what to do.
After 1 hour, you must head to the GE and sell everything you have. The team that gains the most GP after 1 hour will win today's challenge, win the Golden Aprons, and be safe from elimination. The starting point will be at the Lumbridge Bridge. On your way over there, discuss your plan with your teammate, and then we'll get started.
I was not looking forward to the money-making challenges, to be honest. I would say I'm not really known for making money quickly. I was the worst in the last season of Gielinor Games, so I was pretty nervous getting into this.
I was 100% confident. All these big names. I'm seeing B0aty thinking he's the top ginger in the Gielinor Games. GGG, Gielinor Ginger Games, and Matoso's on top.
Here we go, guys. Let's start off the season with a bang. I'll count down from three, and on go, your time starts. 3, 2, 1, go.
Go, go, go. So I'm going fishing troller now.
Where should I go? What should I do? What should I do?
I just saw B0aty go through the gate too.
Where's he going? Just follow it. Just copy him.
No, 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 no
This is not good. We were both Googling money-making method. RuneScape money-making method 2021. RuneScape money-making method rebuild. We had no idea.
I've got a million things going through my head right now.
Yeah, man.
Ideas. I think you go for Hydra then. I'll go for Zora.
Yeah, I think I only need 89k to start a Hydra kill.
89k.
I didn't panic because I had a little trick up my sleeve. I got a Hydra task thinking that if there was a from scratch money making task, Hydra would be great because you kind of only just need a rune crossbow and some bolts and some dehide and you can get a few kills. It was a bit of a cheeky bit of preparation.
We should just give you all the money to get you going ASAP.
I guess
and
so.
And then as soon as you get a kill, you can probably just gear me for Zora off the back of that, right?
Yeah, I think so.
It's like insane. So when the challenge was announced as making money from scratch, I was kind of happy because I've got quite a lot of experience with that. And also my partner Guns Chili is very experienced with that. His entire channel is built off the ground from making money from scratch. Even though Team EU did badly on this challenge last time, I don't have deadweight anchors pulling me down like Rakesy, Sea Engineer, and the others.
I'm just collecting these purple dyes.
Wait, where?
Don't worry about it. Go do your thing. But
okay,
like,
okay.
Because you're 99 thieving, you're in a much better position to thieve, whereas I'm just literally looting.
I find this purple dye, and it's worth 500 GP each. I just do a quick price check. And so I just pick up a few purple dyes.
I just pick up these purple dyes. I'm just going to get like a full inventory. They're worth 500 GP each.
At first, the game plan was centered around getting 30k GP to have enough money to go to Rev Caves. And then after we went to Rev Caves, we were just going to stay there for the rest of the hour.
Tom, your mic is not working.
My mic isn't working. This is so bad. What a bad start.
Oh, is it settled? Oh, look, it's settled. When it comes to making money, it's the first 1K which is important. So I went straight to the RD Knights and started thieving.
I've made a bit of a alteration to our plan now already.
So for the first like minute, we were sat there like, fuck. Everything that we had planned, Soup was like, you can't do it. I really f***ing hope this cunt comes up with a good idea because I am f***ed.
We do the spy deans, but what I've figured out is the wilderness sword that we're about to get, my version, gives me unlimited teleports to the Fountain of Rune. I can recharge glories once we've got enough money.
We did end up coming up with a pretty decent game plan of going to kill spy deans. Checked on the wiki, it was 300k an hour, and we figured, hey, if we can get ourselves 600k together, there's probably some other people in this competition that are too stupid to figure out how to make that much money, and we should be good not to come last.
I'm going for the 6 spy deck in the wilderness, so...
Yeah, that makes sense.
It's just a few more hops, but...
Are you going to Mage Bank or Forthos?
No, I'm doing the Edgeville Dungeon.
Oh, Edgeville Dungeon, okay. We decided that we're going to go ahead and pick up some spider eggs to make our initial cash. That will hopefully buy me a rune pickaxe and get me set up on the rune rocks at the Myths Guild. And then we'll just go from there.
Right, Jen, I'm clever. I've got my chisel. I got my pickaxe. I've got a fairy ring to Zaya and do a bit of bloods.
So I was just doing blood runes because for some reason I've got 77 rune crafting. Can't remember what Jen was doing. Probably not a lot. I think he was looting.
Yeah, that sounds right. What I'm going to do in the meantime, I'm going to go to Edgeville, loot a bit of coinage because I don't have the rune crafting level. So the thoughts are one of us is going to do some blood runes. I'm going to go off and do some looting because I don't have the rune crafting level. See what I can do there. The main goal is barrows and hope we can hit some good RNG and we just pull that one item which is going to win it us.
Keep the axe just in case.
Yeah, I'm not dropping anything.
What else and then buy? How are we getting there? Yeah, we had a game plan. It was basically get the blessed silver sickle as quickly as possible, start collecting Mortmire fungus, and maybe send some barrows runs. It's pretty good money, and there's no RNG involved. And then barrows is obviously super cool, and you could hit it big, and who wouldn't want to see some barrels chest, so.
I'm just trying to think of how to start, because I'm running to get my essence now, and then I'm going to go runecraft some nature runes to get some cash, because I can sell them on the Grand Exchange, and I make double nats at 91. But I think we should just get the net and just chase the impling around the place. It'll be fine.
Ooh.
So that'll work quite well. So if I sell...
Hey! Six toad flex, bro. 12k.
That is beautiful. That's like the best one you can get.
The initial plan was that we're going to rush to get a Draymon staff, go and catch Implings. So this was completely out of my ballpark. I'm not very good at making money with just PVM or, you know, anything like that. So I kind of let Adam take the reins and give me some ideas here. I was just doing his bidding.
Wait, what the heck? There's planks here, dude. I'm taking these planks.
Oh, take those planks, dude. Anything you see on the ground, you pick that shit up.
Last second, I
go to Jimmy and I say, you know what? The plan has changed. I DM Jimmy about 5 seconds before the challenge actually starts. And I say, you know what? Plan has changed. Everything. Throw it out the window. We're going for gout tubers. We're going all or nothing. We picked that shit up because if we don't get any gout tubers, we've got
$0.
We have the planks to fall back on.
He messages me, says, stop, scratch everything. We are going for a gout tuber. Initially, I'm thinking, well, that's insane. And that's why we should definitely do this. This is awesome. That's the best idea I've ever heard.
These clicks, you don't see these clicks from anyone else other than me.
Who's doing clicks like David?
208 bloods. How much? 82k.
That's...
Woo!
Okay, I got my first pyramid.
I've got 40k pretty much.
Already?
Essentially, yeah, from the nails.
Well, I got my bowstring, go to GE. The bowstring sold for 30k, I have 50k now.
Okay, I'm officially buying monkey now. Dude, we're chilling, bro. This is actually a sick idea. I don't know how we didn't think of this earlier. The money-making method was called buying monkey nuts, and it was like 740k XGP an hour. And I was like, this is crazy. And apparently there's just some shop on Apatol where you can go buy nuts for 5GP, sell them to the GE for 140. So, I mean, it was the best idea I had, so I went with it.
Right, I'm buying the nuts. Yes, full stock. So, we spent, I don't know how much, but 3.3k per invent if it sells for that.
Because this is the difficulty, I can actually just force spawn eclectics and sell them 3k each. It might be better cash. Just buy as many impling jars as you can get. I'm gonna do that while you scout worlds, because that'll guarantee us some cash at the start, I think. And every time you find like a magpie, I could maybe just come and get it, and that'll be 20k.
I was fine with catching my eclectics. They were proving to be a decent source of money, and again, it was a guaranteed source where when I was doing it, I would end with a certain amount of gold no matter what.
So I can catch about 300 eclectics an hour, which would be just less than a mil, or we can risk it and go for that. I think, yeah, you hop every world, and if you find a dragon, I'll come get it, and I'll just do eclectics.
Easy. And you do eclectics, okay.
I'm at 23k right now, so we got 30k. It's what, like 15k for a full set of black behind or top bottom?
Yeah, I'm gonna get a few more gargoyle kills and then I'll come meet you at Arty.
Yeah, immediately after we got just about 60,000 GP in total from the Arty Knights and Purple Dyes, we immediately went to the Revenants and then we stayed there the entire time.
So we're gonna steal solo mission strat here of buying steel nails, very cheap. Oh my god. Imagine if there's no. We steal his idea, and then we're gonna sell it to the Grand Exchange, and we're gonna repeat. So I got 800 GP, one of them bought steel nails, iron nails, bronze nails, and sold them in the Grand Exchange. That's the quickest profit we can make.
People hop through those worlds, the bots. Okay,
I need to put player indicator on in case I want to.
The plan for me was to earn enough money for a trident so I could immediately head on over to B0aty and test my luck over there. I have rebuilt on this game time and time again, so I felt pretty confident when I heard that was the challenge.
So I can probably do B0aty for about 40 minutes, I would say. But I'm done with spiders now, and I'm gonna just dump everything, prepare, and then go.
Verf wants to do some B0atys. I'm thinking I might try to go to B0atys at some point, but the first thing I'm going to hopefully do is get myself over to the Rune Rocks.
This is a pretty f***ing good idea.
Yeah, it's not bad, eh? And once we get the f***ing, get enough money for a half invent of glories, that'll start pumping.
Maybe. How much does one Wartmeyer fungus sell for?
They won't show up for me either.
Oh, 426. Well, since I get fungus faster than you, I could keep doing it and I can trade you GP and you can go do something else.
The guy's just taking every single world. Yes, I've got a world. No, who are you? Go away. I'm taking this guy's world. I don't care.
And we didn't take into account that it was going to be full of, like, bots and Iron Man and...
Oh, bro, I swear every world's been taken. I'm getting no implings. Come here. Don't go that far. Come back.
We're
so awesome, dude. We're the most adrenaline pumping
people. I know, man. People are gonna love this content when they watch it.
Oh, they're gonna be like, man, these guys know what they're doing.
These guys really want us to be entertained tonight. Yeah.
I just started thinking about it and I'm like, there's just no way we're gonna get one. But this is funny that we're doing this. You know, if this does go wrong, it is on record that it's his idea. Technically, it's kind of his fault. It's kind of his fault we came in last place, and I was fine with that. Hey, you know, at least if this does not work, it was not my idea. I just got one.
No way.
I f***ing got one.
No
way. I f***ing got one, dude.
Jimmy, kiss me right now.
I f***ing got one, dude.
No.
I got one.
Oh my god.
Holy s***. My very first reaction when I saw that thing pop up is, how the hell do I get this out of that plant? I forgot completely how to get that thing out, and I knew I brought a spade, but I'm thinking, do I dig in front of it? And I did. I dug in front of it once, and I was like, I can't get this thing out. It's stuck. How do I make this into my inventory? What happens now? I feel like I need to, like, take this away.
Do you want to go do barrows? The first thing that came to our brains now was, we are absolutely not last place now. Like, there is no way we get last place with 500k in our pockets. And we actually thought we could come toward the top at this point because we were gonna roll this money into doing barrows now.
Oh my god, you f-
just
legend.
Be so careful with this because there is an option to f- eat this. So
yeah,
just
yeah, I got you. I know. I'm aware of that. All right, I got it. Come on, sick, something good. Let's go. Okay. 50k, 170 astral runes, and 200 bones.
So about halfway through the challenge, Guns Chili was pumping out the money at Hydra, and I'd amassed enough rune ores to be able to afford a really budget Zora setup. Had to be rocking the salad ropes, unfortunately, but it will be enough to get the job done. I'm just thinking about who we could try and, like, save to vote off. Stop manipulating people in the DMs. Yeah, I feel like Ditta and Torvesta is a pretty strong team as well.
Yeah.
Because Ditta is actually, like, everyone thinks he's just a PK, but he's an all-rounder at the game now. Yeah, Verf and Sulu are also pretty good. Even B0aty and skill specs, like, how...
Yeah, you can't rule out. Skill specs is better than everyone thinks he is, still.
I'm on a very strong team this year, and I'm going to start doing things which I don't think others will be doing. I'm going to start DMing everybody. We're going to be forming alliances with all of these players, and we're not going to be getting voted off first week or second week or third week. I want to make friends with everybody and vote people off before they can form an alliance and vote off me.
We were contacted by a team.
I think 30 minutes in, Solar Mission sent me a DM on Discord.
I was messaging Solar Mission.
Solar Mission was on the buzzer.
Jen said, I've just had a message from Solo.
And I believe he also made an alliance with Solar Mission as well.
A certain individual messaged our team offering an alliance.
The first team that I wanted to try and get knocked out was Guns Chili and Solo Mission because they are two very strong players. But we formed an alliance with them very early on.
Guns Chili messaged Nine Rain and told us to vote for Ditter. So I was like, I will vote for anyone you tell me to. I would even go vote for Jimmy if you told me to.
I was sliding in people's DMs from halfway through the challenge. I was killing Zora with one hand, DMing people on the other. And I said we should vote off Ditter, Bitter, and Torvesta, a very strong team, and would be a big threat in the competition.
Do you reckon it's worth trying to kill Zora?
I mean, if you're comfortable doing that, sure, yeah. I mean, I would
might try it.
Okay, but just...
if you give me your money...
Yeah, I could. I got 150k.
Yeah, because Trident's really cheap. So then I came up with a genius idea to do Zora, because we were actually making a decent amount of money from Monkey Knots. And I was like, yeah, right, a Trident is 40k. I can do Zora. I've done 1,000 KC probably about 5 years ago. I wasn't so confident. He was like, are you confident? And I'm like, yeah.
Okay, I don't think I need you. So I'm just going straight to Revenants. Is that cool?
Yeah, I'm going to Revenants too.
52k cash, another invent to go. This is actually insane money making.
Yeah, it's quick from the start. Doing all right for 33 minutes. We're going to make like 800k, bro.
Yeah, we're doing really well.
I'm going on to my first Barrow's chest.
Okay.
All right, let's see it. Good luck.
Good luck.
Okay. Actually, not bad, though. So, my first chest at Barrows, I just wanted to test it out and see how long it would actually take. It didn't really even take too long. It was about like a 5-minute trip. So it gave me the confidence I need to keep going over and over and just kind of hoping I get any sort of item. I mean, anything even as simple as like Torag's plate legs would be a nice 200K boost, and it would just secure us that much closer to the top.
Challenge on the Gielinor Games is super important this year because you can pick a couple to go straight into the banning. So you can pick out the favorites who you think are most likely to win the entire thing. So winning a challenge may just take out the perfect couple.
Kill, let's see what we get.
Oh, come on, come on. Please.
120K.
That's decent, that's decent. Thought I was mistaken. Thought I heard you was.
Tell me how do I feel. Tell me.
I mean, I'm not the best when it comes to the PvP, but like I've been doing LMS. I just got 2 wins in a row actually. Before I came in here at LMS, so.
No.
No way. No what? Way. I just got what? Teleblocked. I just got teleblocked. I just got fucking no, dude. I'm on world you can't really. I'm on world 3-2-1. I'm almost at the entrance. You splashing? You splashing? Please, 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 please. I got the log. I got the log. Oh my god.
Oh,
my god. I can't believe it.
Let's go read here.
Oh.
Good stuff, man. Hold on.
I had everything on me. I had nothing in the bank that was of value for the challenge. Everything that was for the challenge was on my person, and I had no food, no prayer, potions, or anything. Make sure I change worlds.
Nice job. All right. Yeah. Tele to Grand Exchange, and we'll re-gear. Get more arrows and stuff.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think we should go for glories. Just because of the idea that we are actually going for glory, you know what I mean?
Very true.
For the most of the hour, we did spy Deans until around, I'd say, 15 minutes left. We needed to make a little bit more money and we wanted to add a little bit of a risky element to it. So we went and bought some glories. I bought some Ring of Wells and we headed out to the Fountain of Rune.
Oh, I got a mace random. I got a mace random. Oh my God, I'm gonna do that.
Probably worth it.
I got a maze random.
That maze random made me 100k. So yeah, that was pretty awesome.
Let it be a good reward, please. Yep.
How much?
It's just death runes. I got like 800 death runes in my inventory now.
Oh, that's sick. Yeah.
Let's go.
Well over 100k.
I don't think it'd be better if you went to a different location. Where are dragon implings common? Like Mauritania, where settled hunts them. I wonder if that'd be a gold mine.
We were like, okay, what did Swamp Man do? He got so many implings doing something. So we went to the old Mauritania and just kept hopping worlds.
I see we do. It'd be more fun. Let's do it for the content. If we find one impling, that's it. That's the highlight. I don't care. This, yeah, again, call the dragon ASAP if you see it.
We need this impling. Like, it has to appear. If it doesn't appear, we're gone. Like, we're eliminated in round one, you know? And we'd be so disappointed with that.
5 months.
Dots. Dragon Impling! I've got one!
You're joking.
I've got one!
You're joking,
I'm not even kidding! I've got one! Yes! Oh, baby!
Man.
I just need to catch him now. Yes! No, I've got it. We're good. Oh, baby! I'm so happy!
Final minute?
We just doubled the net worth. I'm so happy.
We f***ing nailed this.
I don't know.
I feel like we've done okay.
We've done all right. Right, there's like less than 3 minutes left, so I'm going to kill a skeleton and then the other day.
I should really get scared by nearly that.
We were there for about half an hour, absolutely nothing, drier than our careers. Me and Dave meet at the chest, last chest each, we've had absolutely nothing.
Come on, Jen.
Right, ready?
Come on.
Three,
come on.
Two, one, come on. Guthin's body, 600k.
Yes! Did you really?
Get the...
Guardian! Come on!
The best of us!
We've done it! We've won!
We've done.
Where
we've
are
done.
You?
We've won this!
Where are you?
Won it! What does King Vitoso go and pull a Guthin's play body? 620k? Yes, please.
Come on! Get in!
Oh, God!
To be fair, I didn't look up the price of Guthin's.
623k chest.
Oh, my God. Yeah. We've got over a mil. We've got over a mil.
Okay.
Don't
die. Oh my God, I got a kill stub! I got a kill stub!
No.
Oh my God! Oh my God! We okay. Win the challenge! We win the challenge!
Dude.
Oh my God!
Once I saw that Carol's other top, I honestly got lightheaded because I couldn't believe how lucky we had just gotten in this first challenge. That's a big thing to come out on top in the first challenge. And honestly, I felt like it secured me the victory, although I wasn't entirely sure.
That's 2.3 mil. Oh my God. Oh my God. Come. World 485.
Now, Kevin, he screamed so much, it started getting annoying in my ear. I kind of had to mute him for a bit, but he was super happy.
It's not a competition, Tom, because you'd lose. I got Darox Great Axe.
Really? What? What? Oh, you're so lucky. I got nothing.
Can we go sell and see how much it's worth? 600K.
What?
Yeah, extra 600K. I get a second item, a Darox Great Axe. And honestly, at that point, I was assured.
Oh boy. Well done, you guys, on finishing your first challenge. I've got to say, some cash jacks are looking pretty good, and others, well, I'm hoping that today was just an off day for you guys. Over 10 million GP was earned between the 10 teams. Let's see who made the most. In 10th place today, earning 395k, were Nine Rain and Flood.
Oh.
Underdog story. Underdog story.
Another Dragon Warhammer.
To be honest, it was a small brain, big heart move. Flutton and I, let's be real, we're underdogs. People see us that way. I think we're going to be able to slide by some of the earlier challenges. We're not going to get voted off. Totally botching the first challenge, I think, plays perfectly into our master plan.
Since you guys are the last place team, you will automatically receive one vote heading into the banning. In 9th place, with 654k, B0aty and skill specs.
Oh,
we got carried hard.
Dude, what?
One thing I'm really bad at is I've been playing Iron Man for now so long that I always forget that I can just go buy items off the Grand Exchange that are really good. So things like, I think a lot of people bought tridents. I just sleep on the fact that a trident is 37k and is an incredibly strong weapon. I don't realize I could go buy a dragon shimmy and some other stuff and maybe go kill gargoyles.
In 8th place, with 673k, Jimmy and Settled. In 7th place, with 713k, Eviescape and Skidler. In 6th place, with 720k, Ditterbitter and Torvesta. In 5th place, with 786k, Poison Potion and Kemp Q. In 4th place, with 935k, Verf and Zulu. In 3rd place, with 1,167,000 GP, Tanzu and Virtoso.
Oh, boy.
Oh, shit.
The top two highest earning teams, Guns Chili and Solo Mission, and Framed and Sea Engineer. Taking home the first golden aprons of the season, with a whopping 3.2 million GP earned in 1 hour.
What the fuck?
Are Framed and Sea Engineer.
Let's fucking go!
Hell yeah!
Let's go, baby!
No way.
I asked if she made more than 10k this time.
The second that Stoop announced that we had won first place, we immediately started screaming and became power hungry. We knew we had the potential to immediately put one of the other teams into the banning. So thanks to the RNG gods being on our side, we were the first team with golden aprons.
My reaction after winning is just a blessed framed. I made like 50k, he made 3 mil. Like, without him, I would be in the bottom.
Congratulations, you guys, on the golden aprons. With this power, you two receive immunity from going into today's banning, and you'll also get to choose one team to go straight into the elimination. You two can now relax, and congratulations once again.
Some of these teams do really have to just rely on luck to get them through, but the thing is, with luck, it's always going to come to an end at some point, and players as skilled as Skidler and myself, obviously, we just rely on our skill and not our luck, and that's going to prevail in the end.
It's now time for everyone else to head to this season's voting location, the Cove. On our way over there, discuss with your teammate which team you'd like to vote for. I'll meet you guys there. Like a baby, beautiful trees outside. Sky is a bright blue, you see storm clouds. Storm clouds. You give me bad vibes, bad times, bad nights with you. Yeah, I get bad energy, sick pleasure from you. Welcome to the Cove. Here, you guys will be casting your votes for which team you want to send into the banning. One by one, you'll head to the voting area and cast your votes. Good luck, and make sure to not be the first team voted in. Solo mission, go ahead and get us started.
This season, the challenges matter. There are golden aprons and there's a bottom pair. But what matters even more is the voting system. The team that gets the most votes, they're in the bottom too. If I can get people to vote for others and not us, we're not going to be down there. So that is definitely the plan. And I'm starting to sow those seeds right now. I am voting for Ditter Bitter and Torvesta because I've been constructing an absolute madness behind the scenes. And if people keep their word, they will also be voting for Ditter and Torvesta. I've been organizing this since halfway through the challenge, so hopefully it pays off.
This secret is best kept with you, but I guess the viewers will find out. But we have there's a UK alliance, so we're gonna go for Ditter.
My vote today is gonna be for PP and Kemp. Now I know what you're thinking, why aren't you voting for skill specs? I wanna keep him for a little bit longer, and then we can kill him off later.
I will be voting out Kemp Q, a poison potion. I think that with the knowledge poison potion has gathered doing his little series about weird things in the game, and Kemp Q himself also has been doing weird stuff for years. So those two, I don't know what kind of knowledge they have, but it's very clear me and Torvesta are lacking in that department.
I am voting for Kemp Q and poison potion this week, simply because I have an alliance with Ditter Bitter and Torvesta, and that's who they told me they're voting for. I don't know why. I'm just a sheep in this, and that's how I'm casting my vote.
We are voting for Kemp Q and poison potion. I just f***ing hate those guys, man.
I'm going to be casting my vote to Ditter Bitter and Torvesta. I believe that mine and Dave's downfall is going to be PvP. They are two of the strongest PvPers in the game, personally, so I think it'd be good to get those out early.
Ditter Bitter and Torvesta. Nothing against them, it's just Ditter Bitter, isn't it?
But obviously, with skill specs on our team, the audience knows already who it's going to be, and we've decided to vote for Torvesta's team.
Torvesta and Ditter, mate, in the bin. Iron Man changed him, bro. Send him to the bin.
Torvesta and Ditter again. Both of our votes. They make me scared to compete, and I want less scary things in my experience here.
My vote today is going to be for Ditter Bitter and Torvesta on the gamble that there's going to be some PKing challenges soon, and they're probably the best PKers in this entire group of 20 people, so that's where my vote's going today.
I'm
going
to be voting for Torvesta and Ditter Bitter. They've got the prowess and the PvP skills, and that's going to be a huge advantage for them.
All right, Torvesta and Ditter Bitter are probably going to flop every PVM challenge, but they're both really way too good at PvP, so they've got to get the boot, and I hope to get kicked out this round.
Ditter? I just need him out of here, you know? It's too much time being here. He should be gambling crypto.
I will vote for Mr. Ditter Bitter.
Ditter and Torvesta. We have an understanding with Chili and Solo Mission to both vote against them.
I am casting my vote for Ditter Bitter's team.
I think Flutton and I are in a bit of a situation, and maybe our hands were forced, but I'm down to play that game. I'm down to play that game.
All right, guys, welcome back. Hope you all had a great time at the Cove. I think it's about time we reveal which team got the most votes, and we'll be heading into the first banning of the season.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no.
Oh, baby.
Three teams today received votes. Receiving one vote were Nine Rain and Flutton.
We're not a threat. Yes.
Receiving four votes were Kemp Q and Poison Potion.
Oh, my God. What?
Okay.
What have we done?
Me and Kemp were talking before this, saying, yeah, no, we're probably not the biggest threat. People aren't going to worry too much about us. And here we go into second. So that's certainly got me a little bit worried for the next couple of rounds.
And finally, with 14 votes for their team.
What?
Gilfrex is smiling right now.
Jake, imagine it, Jake. Imagine it.
No, don't ask.
Ditter Bitter and Torvesta.
Oh my god.
Good job, guys. Oh,
you guys are f***ing rats.
See you later, buddy.
One of you.
What? No way. We got that's like literally 80% of people voted for us. Like literally most people voted for us. They're trying to get us out first round. So I'll actually take that as a compliment, but I was so surprised.
I was completely blindsided, man. We got 13 votes. I was like, surely we're just going to sneak under the radar here. No one actually thinks we're that big of a threat because like I didn't even play in the last games. Like surely they don't know what we're thinking. Everyone else, like 13 votes have all gone for our team. I had no idea. I was panicking.
I am very happy that everyone's kept their word. Trust has been built today. Bonds have definitely not been broken. And I actually had a conversation with Ditter saying that we were going to vote for, I think it was Kemp Q and Peefy, yeah. And I said that me and Tom, yep, we've got your back.
Now, Framed and Sea Engineer, since you two won today's challenge, you get to use your Golden Apron power and automatically send one team to go into the banning versus Ditter Bitter and Torvesta. Which team have you guys decided on?
Man, listen, this wasn't an easy choice, but we have to go with who we think.
It was a very easy choice, by the way.
We have to go with who we think some of the strongest competitors are going to
be. No, dude, don't give us.
Oh, Jimmy, we're doomed. Fuck,
man.
So, we ultimately came to the conclusion that Skidler and Eeviescape are going to be the ones sent there.
Me and Rain were discussing who to vote out. It was easy. I just said Skidler and Eeviescape. He said okay. However, our ally, Solo Mission, we had to convince him as well, and he wanted to take out the B0aty and Skillsbakes. We're DMing back and forth consistently, nonstop, because we wanted our ally to trust us and feel like they have a say in everything, and I need to make sure that Framed feels like he has a say in it.
We were considering B0aty, but he earned 3K, so...
Yeah. Wait, have I just been f***ed?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes.
You never think you're going to be the one to be picked, especially when it's the first round. Like, the odds are so heavily in your favor to not be the ones, and then bang.
Eeviescape and Skidler, come on down, you guys.
Put it like this. I respect you guys in the sense that I think you're a legitimate threat. So that's why we're trying to send you out.
Dev, I'm flattered, mate. Thank you.
Yeah.
Absolutely caught me off guard. I was so shocked. My mouth almost hit the floor. Kevin, I'm going to tell you this right now, okay? If I ever find out where you live, I'm coming there, okay? And I've got a plastic that I'm going to throw at your face.
So these are the teams heading into the first banning of the season. Winner stays, loser goes home. To fight for your place to stay in the game, you guys will be playing a little game called PK to Stay.
Yes.
Ooh, whoa, you think you're going to win this?
Oh, well, that was the best dance. You're pretty washed up. Random.
Both teams must use the GP they earned during today's challenge to buy gear and supplies to PK with.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we can do that.
Ooh.
You'll then fight it out in Clan Wars in a 2v2 multi-PvP fight. The team that kills both players on the other team first will win the banning and stay in the game. Loser is the first team out of Gielinor Games. Go ahead and gear up, and I'll meet you guys at Clan Wars.
Make sure you smash him, Elliot, bro. Smash the cunt.
when we found out that the money was going to be used for the gear and the supplies, my first thought was as many brews as possible. That's the most health we're going to get restored per inventory slot. So we basically just went in and thought, if we can just rag bolt them down, we can stock up on as many brews as we can.
We should just buy range rag gear. We should just be in tanky gear and bolt people, and it just comes down to like range RNG, you know, it's gonna be bolts and DDSs or bolts and simmies, whatever. But then I was like, do you think one of them's gonna try and take freezes and just DD focus one person? And I was like, you know what? They're not gonna be fucking boring. They're gonna do it. They're gonna take tribrid, so I'll match it. You gear up in the range tank and I'll take the tribrid.
With the cash we had, bolt rag is superior, and I knew if there's any chance that one of them would bring mage, it'd be Skiddler. He would be thinking he's some sort of master high. Bolt rag is just too overpowered with that little GP to use. So I was pretty confident going into it. I think we had like 12 brews each in our inventory. We had a DDS, we had a recoil, like we were fully set up for that fight.
We filled our invent with brews and got in full tank, and we had a DDS switch. Because if we were planning on just rag ranging, because I think that was a meta, not spending any money on mage.
All right, you guys, both teams can go and pot up and let's get this fight started.
Okay, DDS right off the bat. We're focusing wag it.
Yeah, I think we freeze Torvesta.
Yep.
And then just constantly bolt and barrage Ditto.
Yep, I think you're right.
Yeah, so Torvesta and I actually ended up in the first banning, but we're not here to go out first. We're here to go out last and take out everyone in our way, so I'm hoping we can stay here a bit longer.
Jake and I might be two of the biggest f***ing idiots that play this game, but there are two bigger f***ing idiots, and that's Ditto Bitter and Torvesta.
Torvesta and Ditterbitter, Eviescape and Skiddler, welcome to the first banning of the season. Let's get this fight started. Go.
Snake.
Yeah, they did snake it, but I can just go for him, it's fine.
Nice.
I'm not hitting anything, yeah, actually. But if he goes into his robes, he's bolt that.
That's it?
Dude, he's getting f***ed up. Yo, just eat up. Use your bruise, be careful.
Oh my god, Torvesta is getting absolutely cooked, eh?
Oh my god.
Okay, I'm gonna DD on them too. They can't do that. They can't do that if I DD on you too.
Oh, that's you are clever.
If I DD on you too, how can they DD on you? You know what I mean?
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, DDS him.
Yep, that's really clever.
Nice. Okay, bolt that on his ropes.
Fake you the DDS, remember. Keep faking the DDS.
Our game plan without actually seeing them was just go in, use our DDS specs off the bat on Eviescape because we thought he was going to be the weaker link in terms of PvP. But as soon as we got there, we saw that Skiddler was in mage, so we instantly changed and we just focused him the entire time. Because every time he puts those robes on, he just got bolted a big number and he'd have to like brew down or just not do any damage back. He's getting f***ed up, dude. He has no rigor room. All Jake has is bolts. Drink your stamina, by the way. Drink your stamina, yeah.
Yeah, I did.
All right, we should focus down one of them, honestly.
Yeah. Hold on, I'm getting cooked.
Yeah, who are we focusing?
I'm gonna focus Ditto.
Okay.
Listen, with the cash stacks they had, anything could happen. It wasn't as if they were using meta gear. It was around 700k, so I think anyone could have won it in the end.
I'm just trying to catch a freeze on Torvesta. I think the freezes were a big mistake, by the way.
Yeah, I agree. Bringing the freezes was absolutely the worst decision we could have made. The only reason we brought them along is because we thought both of them would bring freezes and we wanted to counteract that.
I got him.
Nice. Oh, I've just attacked you, for sake.
Oh my god, I've just attacked you as well.
We're in pieces.
Keep on faking that DDS.
I'm just gonna put on augury whenever he tries to freeze me because it just gives me more mage defense. Okay, I'm frozen. You go, come DD under me.
Well, the plan was to focus one person. There's no point switching. That's what they did. They were focusing me. Then they switched to Ditto, which is a bad idea. You need to drain the other person's food and completely get them out and then start the next one.
I just bolt him whenever he could. Just keep spam bolting him because otherwise he's useless too. You know what I mean? He's getting f***ed up, dude.
Get a DDS on if you can.
Hold on, I'm getting cooked.
He's going to be spam clicking Torvesta as well. Fuck, 34 with the deeds.
And then you saw Elliot with his little salad robes, bro, looking like a Caesar salad. It was terrible, man. And the second he put those on, constantly getting bolted, you knew it was over.
Thought it was a good matchup, but as soon as you announced it was like a 2v2, Torvesta and Ditter, I think, do have the strongest PvP team in the whole of the Gielinor Games. And I saw that Elliot was wearing Mystic Boots, and as soon as I saw that, I was like, he's brought barrages, so they've lost already. Like, as soon as I saw that, it was game over.
Harvest doesn't work in Claymores.
No way.
I swear to God, I have no bolts.
Dude, Eviescape ran out of bolts. He's boxing me. I'm telling you, bro, we're too good.
Who the f*** knew that Clan Wars didn't allow the Arvas to work? I went and got an Arva specifically to save bolts, and it came back to bite me in the ass, and I had to punch my way out of that fight.
Oh my God. No. He was poking me for like 10 seconds.
They've got DDSs. I mean, it's just over.
Is he out of food yet? What?
I don't know.
I've got so
I don't
much
have
food any... left. How much food do you have?
I've got hella food left too. Don't worry about it.
I've got so many brews.
I've got like 6 brews left and all my anglerfish.
I'm just ruined for my life.
Yeah. Oh man, how does it not work in Clan Wars?
As soon as I saw that they'd both come in range rag, I was like, yeah, okay. This is kind of over unless we get extremely lucky and like get really early momentum, but that didn't happen. And we just basically got battered. I have no bolts left either. Oh my God, I caught a freeze.
Go on, son, get under him.
Yep, get ready to type. Skill specs is next.
Yep. Well, it turns out Jake and I are actually bigger idiots.
All right, boys, I'm not gonna f***ing drag it on any longer. Go on.
Get ready?
Yep, done.
No more Mr. Nice Guy, you know? I was coming in here hoping to have a little bit of fun with my friends, but it's instantly, you know, it's appeared to me that they're all out to get me. So me and Torvesta, you know, we've got a list of names and we're going to slowly start taking them off.
We are extremely happy not to get first rounded. That's just the goal all along. At least make it past the first round. And also, it wasn't even a PvP one and we made it past. So happy days.
Great banning, you guys. Torvesta and Ditterbitter, congratulations on winning. You guys are still in the game with the chance to win the big grand prize. But with every winner comes a loser, and those losers today are Eviescape and Skiddler.
Listen, mate, no one wants to be the first one out, but I think if you're going to be the first one out, you have to take it gracefully. And I just want to say, it's f***ing bullshit, man. The only reason I lost is because of RNG and that f***ing prick, Kevin.
I don't know. I was kind of gutted because I really enjoyed watching the Gielinor Games last season and I was really excited to be part of it.
You guys are some of the funniest people I've ever met, and I think I speak for everyone when I say that we are going to miss you guys. Just wasn't your day today.
Feels bad for those two. They're both extremely charismatic and fun. I would love to see more of them in the episodes, but unfortunately, they're out of here. Fortunately, they're both really good players. So as a competitor, I'm glad to see them go.
Take it easy, guys.
Jake, Elliot, I'm very sorry. You guys are my two very handsome friends, but you know, we're put in this position by 13 other people, and I'm gonna do my best to get some revenge for you guys.
And that wraps up episode 1 of Gielinor Games Season 2. What a first episode. I cannot wait to show you guys what I have in store for you next week.
It's at least good that Eviescape and Skiddler got knocked out right away, because again, they were a strong team. But now we're going to have to keep our eye out on Ditter and Torvesta.
We've got to up our game. We have to try and win some challenges to avoid getting voted out. We have to go for the win. We have to take risks.
Next week, another team is going home. To prepare, I'd practice my switches if I were you. I'll see you all very, very soon. Eviescape, Skiddler, follow me.